Assalamu alaikum. Peace be on you. Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, honorable ministers, honorable members of parliament, excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to welcome you all in today's inaugural session of the Dhaka Global Dialogue 2019. The very presence of our leader, Honorable Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, my colleagues, cabinet ministers, senior officials, and distinguished guests and delegates from all over the world is a manifestation of our shared aspiration and collective will for a better future through a joint and forward-looking development and strategic cooperation facing the evolving international realities. Bangladesh takes pride to promote the concept of pro-people, pro-planet, more inclusive, more peaceful, sustainable world for all, where no one is left behind, being included in the SDG. And Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina promoted the concept of people's empowerment, a peace-centric development model that was adopted at the UN with consensus in 2012. And he states that human beings will be faced with emerging and newer challenges. And to manage them effectively, it is necessary to empower people, both men and women. And in order to empower them, it identified six interlinked variables, such as end of poverty and hunger, inclusion of deprived or left outs, providing quality education, newer technology and improved skills and training, gainful employment, and right to participate in governance, and end of terrorism and extremism. In the document, The Future We Want, at the Rio+20 Summit in 2012, followed by 2030 Agenda for Development in 2015, the global leadership adopted the development initiatives that will promote five P's, namely people, planet, peace, prosperity, and partnership. The goals of Future We Want or that of SDGs cannot be achieved without rock-solid political commitment and collaboration and partnership. Ladies and gentlemen, today's Dhaka dialogue, I'm confident, will be a key event to discuss, analyze, and even chart out changing regional and global political order and the position and role of Bangladesh vis-a-vis the emerging international setting. Dhaka dialogue, hopefully, will be a permanent platform for all relevant bodies and stakeholders to look across the challenges, solutions, opportunities, and ideas regarding development, environment, globalization, and even people-centric governance. Time and strategic location has given the larger Indo-Pacific region a clear advantage, and it will be a pity if we cannot build on the existing successes presented by the Asian century. In this respect, I believe the Dhaka dialogue will set up an example for exploring ways and means of human development based on mutual trust and respect, common prosperity, and shared responsibility and partnership. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, you all are aware that despite many challenges, Bangladesh has often been cited by UN as a role model for development, a star of women empowerment, and the Wall Street Journal termed it as the standard bearer of the South. Our country has continued to prosper over the last 10 years and has recorded, as per Asian Development Bank, the highest economic growth rate among the 45 Asia-Pacific countries, with its GDP growth rate at around 8.13%. However, our secret for economic development is Sheikh Hasina magic, her strong determination and leadership quality, and our collective commitment towards fulfillment of the dream of the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, to make Bangladesh a Sunar Bangla, the Golden Bengal, a prosperous and stable economy. And thanks to the vision, pragmatism, and statesmanship of our Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, Bangladesh is now truly on its journey towards becoming a mid-income country by 2021, and hopefully will attain the SDGs by 2030, become a developed country by 2041 and a prosperous Delta by 2100. To achieve that vision, we continue to embark upon pragmatic programs for rapid economic and social development, poverty eradication, sustainable growth, protection of the environment, use of digital technology, and more importantly, human resource development are some of the key features of our development strategy. We found poverty and inequality are two major obstacles. Bangladesh has achieved one of the fastest poverty reduction rates in the world, with poverty rate dropping almost half from 41.5% to 21.3% in 2018. Extreme poverty from 24% to 11.3%, and we propose to reduce it by another 5% within the next 5 years. Our extensive and rural development initiatives and social protection programs like My Village, My Town, Asrayon, Bidhoba Bhata, Food for Work, BJP Card, Amar Bari, Amar Khamar, etc., have contributed to our inclusive development and reduction of inequality. Bangladesh has been ranked 34th in the World Economic Forum's Inclusive Development Index, leaving other countries in this region far behind. World Bank showed that Bangladesh lifted 8 million out of poverty within the last 6 years, from 2010 to 2016. Therefore, I term Bangladesh development as a humane development. Ladies and gentlemen, Bangladesh's vulnerability to climate change impacts is well known and well documented, losing almost 2% of GDP annually due to this menace. However, on this front, the story of Bangladesh is not only the story of vulnerability. In fact, it is completely the opposite. Ours is a story of adaptive resilience, which could be emulated by other countries under similar threats. With almost no resources, we are addressing the consequences of the climate change and natural disaster in our own ways. As early as 2009, Bangladesh adopted a comprehensive climate change strategy and set up two trust funds to meet the challenges, although our contribution to global warming is almost nil or negligible. At present, we spend more than 1% of GDP in combating climate change. At the same time, we are pursuing a low carbon development path with increasing emphasis on renewables, energy efficiency, and better energy conservation. Over the last few years, we have installed more than 5 million solar home systems in off-grid areas. Within the next 5 years, we are going to increase our tree coverage to nearly 24%. So far, Bangladesh has created 0.2 million hectares of dedicated coastal forest as protection from tidal surges and calamities, in addition to 600,000 hectares of the Sundarbans mangrove forest, a carbon sink. From our climate smart agriculture technologies to 80,000 disaster volunteers, from floating agriculture, salinity resistant and water prone crops to the grassroots level detailed management plan for any kind of disaster, it is all a human tale, a tale of tremendous preparedness, unity, resilience, and local innovation of our people, which has been amply manifested once again just yesterday when Storm Bulbul attacked us. Excellencies, under the direct guidance of the Honorable Prime Minister, we have given high priority to human resource development, to education, health, energy, infrastructure, skill development, digitization, and adaptation towards climate change impacts. To start with, for ensuring equal access to education, millions of free books are being distributed among students up to the secondary level. In addition, thousands of digital labs have been introduced to classrooms. Different stipends are being provided to more than 20 million students. Recently, a project of providing lunch during school time has also been undertaken for students. E-learning and massive teachers' training are ongoing to ensure quality education. To reach the poorest and the last one in the line with basic healthcare, we have established a network of 18,000 community clinics and union health centers so that the emergency and basic healthcare reaches people's door, including those who are differently able. And again, most of it is free of cost. To provide variety of government services at people's doorsteps under the guidance of Prime Ministers, IT advisor Shajib Wajed, we have introduced 333 hotlines and 999 emergency lines and my ministry in order to provide better services to our people, especially to 11 million diaspora, has introduced Dutabas apps, a digital technology by which nearly 34 services could be received with fingertips, saving time, money, and visits. We consider SDGs implementation as a continuation of our MDG efforts. Bangladesh was one of the few countries who did attain almost all of the MDG targets. Realization of the MDGs helped Bangladesh towards graduation from the LDC status, fulfilling all three criteria for graduation. Now we intend to do the same with the implementation of SDGs. For this, we took a three-pronged approach. These are mobilization of resources, both fund and technology, capacity building, and people's empowerment at all stages of decision-making process. We understand the implementation of SDGs require much greater long-term and sustained flow of resources. The preliminary assessment reveals that in Bangladesh, we may require around $930 billion of additional synchronized expenses for full implementation of the SDGs. For a developing country like Bangladesh, even with our impressive growth rate and social innovations, the burden is truly great. Therefore, we need partnership, regional partnership, government-to-government partnership, government and business partnership, government and academic plus NGOs, think tank and philanthropic partnership, the South-South and North cooperation, and innovative finances and technology to achieve the goals. Moreover, to face the upcoming advent of fourth industrial revolution, a dramatic technological innovation, we are building partnerships where the government, private sector, academia, community, and civil society all are working together. Bangladesh has now the second largest pool of ICT freelancers in the world, almost 600,000. Distinguished delegates, you all know, out of humanitarian consideration and to avert a disaster, Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina gave shelter to 1.1 million forcibly displaced Rohingya, persecuted Rohingyas of Myanmar. Now, it is the responsibility of the global community, including our neighbors, to do more to ensure their quick and sustainable repatriation and reintegration in Myanmar. This is an issue created by Myanmar, and solution also lies with them. Voluntary return of the Rohingya to their homes in the Rakhine state in safety, security, and dignity is a crying need of the hour. Excellencies, we are truly living in the Asian century. The countries in the south, India, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, and many others in the Southeast and East Asia are growing at a much faster rate than all other countries in the world. However, it is not only the rate of growth, but the sustainability and just distribution of benefits of that growth that makes these fast-growing economies so important. However, I personally see a vast area of possible future cooperation among us. It is undeniable fact that inter-regional trade and physical connectivity are still insignificant compared to their true potential. So, through our Dhaka dialogue, our active collaboration and cooperation will be further successful to expand the areas of cooperation and understanding for our common benefit. Before I conclude, I have one message. Without peace and stability, no country or region can prosper. No one can achieve their goals. Of late, there are varieties of media, including social media, at times promote venom of hatred and intolerance. Such venom of hatred and ignorance results in violence and wars. In order to have a sustainable world of peace and stability, it is important that we all help creating a mindset of respect for each other, a mindset of tolerance, irrespective of ethnicity, color, religion, or background. To inculcate such a mindset, I urge everyone, parents, guardians, teachers, opinion builders, think tank, media, community leaders, leaders of mandir, mosques, synagogues, churches, and the government to join hands together for a sustainable world of peace and stability. Let the Dhaka dialogue take a lead to this end. I again thank BIIS and ORF for jointly organizing this dialogue, and especially my colleague, State Minister Shahryar Alam MP and Naeem Rajak MP, and assure you our wholehearted support and wish this dialogue a grand success. Let us open our mind, and let me conclude by echoing our great Bengali poet Rabindranath Tagore. And he said, and I quote, Antar mamo bikoshito karo antarotaro he, jukto karo he shabha sange, mukto karo he bando, antar mamo bikoshito karo antarotaro he, ujjal karo, nirmal karo, nandito karo, sundar karo he, jai Bangla, jai Bangabandhu.